Hi guys, it is time to get wibbly wobbly and timey wimey in the workshop. Stay tuned, it'll be fun. Hey guys, welcome back to the workshop. We are continuing on with our wonderful, wonderful 1985/86 Doctor Who FASA miniatures. We finished our Sergeant Benton of Unit. So he's finished. Now we are moving on to our wonderful Time Lord player character. Now there's been absolutely no there is no color scheme for this guy. So now my imagination gets to go wherever I want it to go. And you know, I've been thinking a while on this guy because I haven't been quite sure how I want to go with him. But I'm kind of gonna take him into the realm that I paint my Adeptus Sororitas, or my Sisters of Battle, from Games Workshop. Or at least I'm going to use that color palette. One, I'm familiar with it. Two, well, I just really like it. But we're going to change a few things up, I think. I think we're going to change a little couple of things up. We're going to give him a yellow coat a la Freddie Mercury. So, we are going to start with the wonderful base of Averland Sunset. It's a great base pretty much for anything that you're going to paint yellow. I use it on one of my other armies that I play in. I play for Warhammer. I'm quite familiar with yellow. And again, we are going to just start straight out with the make it look bigger glasses, because I love these things. Turn the light on, blind you guys at all, and then we are going to get to it. And at least here, I can be as crazy and as messy as I want to be. Because we will clean things up later on. Not too worried about, you know, making a huge mess. And I'm not worrying about the chains, the loops on the jacket, or what looks to be suspenders. Again, I'll pick all of that out later on. When it comes time to get to those details. So this is one of the first miniatures. Well, no, I can't say that. There's been a couple of other miniatures where I've been able to, you know, satisfy that creative itch that you get every now and then. I mean, you know, following a rigid color palette is not too bad for a while. But every now and then, you like to just kind of stretch your creative brain and just go with what's with what you kind of want to do. And I'm kind of deciding colors on the fly. I'm not 100% sure of all my colors yet. But, you know, it'll all get figured out. It'll be interesting how he turns out, and how the colors just kind of talk to me. Like I said, I have no real outline for this character, no pre-thought color schemes, no real nothing. I'm just kind of letting it go. And just kind of seeing where it takes me. Actually, it might not be suspenders. Getting a solid yellow is, or a nice solid yellow is always kind of the hard part. So, you know, it takes a few coats to get you where you want slash need to be. Wondering if I should copy this into the hat. I should make the hat a completely different color. Probably just keep the hat yellow. To make sure that I get into each of those fancy knots. So, I think I'm gonna make the hat the same color. Because, I mean, it kind of looks like a marching band leader or something. Or now, well, just for funsies and because it's my miniature and I can. a little bit more yellow. Give it a little bit of water, thin it down. Kind of looks like he's got rain boots on, but you know. That's okay. I kind of like how this character is shaping up, the colors anyway. You know, maybe he's part of a conspiracy theory, and this is his way of avoiding. You know, it's kind of like a tinfoil hat. Oh no! The right thing to do is to wear yellow boots. Trust me, I'm the doctor. I don't know. You know, I bet you that there's some school somewhere that yellow is there, as at least one of their school colors. There we are, I think. I think we've more or less covered our yellows. There we are. I think that's looking absolutely spectacular. Now, I could find my color wheel. That'd be great help. But since I can't, and actually all of my electronics are gone at the moment. Kept it nearby for just such an occasion. There it is. I knew I had it. So let's go to our yellow. And directly across from is purple. They say that violet is the complementary color, which, I should have known, but. Let's see what I got for purples. You have a little gaudiness. Yeah, we're just gonna go all over the board. They're all complementary, contrasting colors, I should say. No complementary. what I'm going to do is I'm going to go stick it on scale green for the pants. No. No, I don't. So yeah, this is just a crazy, crazy paint job. There's no real rhyme or reason. I just thought it would be something to kind of break out of. Be a little nicer. Try and keep your edges a little tighter. There we go. Now, while we're now we have that done, what we're going to do. We're going to give our yellow a wash. Wash down the yellow. Give it some definition. A happens is we put the yellow, and it's gonna run into all the creases and giving us a darker overall look. I can't forget the boots. There we are. We've washed down all the yellow. We've given him the shade that he needs. Come back and look amazing. And so we're gonna stay off the stegodon for a while we let that dry. But we are going to see if we can do some of the skin. We're going to take our Bugsman Glow, handy dandy Bugsman Glow, our Citadel medium layer brush. Trying to paint the fleshy parts. We're going to switch brushes from our medium layer, which is kind of like, bit of a hammer. To our back brush. Which has a mighty finer tip on it. Huh. That happens from time to time. So nothing we can't handle. Kind of interesting. This is sort of like, you know, I've been able to sort of see the face. But now this is almost like a face reveal. Now we'll know what it really looks like. Things are coming along quite nicely with this guy right here. Yeah. Nice. And for his hair, we're just going to go bro. Because bro. We're going to start with Thorondra Brown. Thondia Brown. Weird. All right. Oh well. Whatever. I think I'll leave the mustache for now. Do that a little bit later. Today is a day. I'm getting all my colors mixed up. I'm just putting on my Katie and flush tone to lighten up all the skins. I'll have to fix some of the purple. Oh, that's okay. Things are okay. Well, I mean, we can't forget little areas, like, you know, under the chin. And if your pink color goes into the hair, that's okay. You're gonna kind of touch those both up later anyway. Yeah. I think that's good. Clean up your brush. Now we're going to move on to. Now we're moving on to the. Stick it on scale green. Because I have a plan. I think it might be a neat plan. I want this color. Well, you'll see. Oh my God. Cannot get my crap together. Didn't look great. Although, to be fair, I did make a few oopsies on the pants, and I pulled the wrong color, but the right color for fixing up the pants. So, yeah, I guess my head was in the tidy up game. As opposed to, the continuing the continuation of the miniature. Right, now that I've pretty sure I've fixed the pants, let's go to the right color, which is our stick-it-on scale green. Hey, there we go. We're going to do is we are going to do the fringe on the shoulders. Yeah, so for at least the moment, it's gonna be the fringes and stuff. Other things. Up here. And the fringes here on the bottom. As well as the trim. There we are, at least for the moment. But as you can see, I'm gonna continue on with this guy and try and make him look pretty darn awesome. But for the moment, we are more or less out of time. There we are. Course, try your best to keep your space tidy and put away your brushes and paints as you go. And, as you can see, he's kind of a weird random assortment of colors. Some colors I'm used to working in, some of the colors not as much, or at least, you know, for main colors. So we're just gonna leave it at that, and I will continue on. You will eventually see the finished pictures of these guys on my Instagram, and the Instagram is the.paintslinger. Go ahead, check it out. I have the majority of stuff that I painted both personally and for the show. So please go ahead, check it out. If you like it, subscribe. And as always, stay safe. Be safe, but most of all, paint safe, and we'll see you next time in the workshop.